Welcome to this video on using SnapGene to create primers to amplify a coding sequence and then using the primers to generate a PCR product. You will learn how to incorporate restriction sites into the primers as 5 prime extensions so the PCR product can be used in restriction cloning. To start, open your sequence of interest, switch to sequence view, and locate the region for your forward primer. Now you can define the forward primer's initial binding region at the coding sequence's start. In this example, you want the binding region of your primers to have a melting temperature of around 55 degrees Celsius. Click and drag to display the predicted TM for the selection. For example, selecting 19 nucleotides gives a melting temperature of 56 degrees. To convert the selection to a primer, go to Primers and add Primer. Since this will be the forward primer, choose to make the primer from the top strand sequence. Enter a name for the primer and add a short description if you want. Next, click at the 5 prime end of the new primer sequence to add an extension. SnapGene allows you to add extra sequences by simply typing a sequence. Or you can use the insertion tools to add codons, restriction sites, or sequences for short features. For this example, you want to add a cell 1 restriction site to the start of the primer. Using the insertion tool, you can type the enzyme name or use the dropdown to select your desired enzyme. Many restriction enzymes cut more efficiently if they are not at the immediate end of a sequence. Check the option and use the dropdown if you want SnapGene to add extra upstream bases automatically. Now click Insert to add the site and upstream bases to the primer. The new extension will be red, and a green bar will mark the cell 1 site. You can hover to see the site name. Now click Add Primer to Template to add the new primer to your sequence. Then repeat the process to design a reverse primer. Again, select a region to give a TM of about 55 degrees. This time, choose bottom strand to create a reverse primer. For the reverse primer, add a KPN1 site to the 5 prime end and add extra bases. Then, give the primer a name and click Add Primer to Template to create your reverse primer. Finally, click Save to save the 2 new primers on the sequence. Now that your PCR primers pair are designed, you can simulate the PCR by choosing Actions and PCR. To set the primers for PCR, either click on the first primer in the main window and shift-click on the second primer, or use the drop-down menus. Once you have defined the primers, enter a name for the product, then click the PCR button to generate a new PCR product file. The product file shows that the 2 restriction sites have been added to the sequence. Switch to history view to see a summary of the PCR steps. You can also switch to the primers view to see the new primers. Expand the rows to see the sequence and other information. To export your primer sequences for ordering, select and export them as a text file by going to Primers Export selected primer data. Export to your project folder, where you can copy and paste the text into an online primer order form. And that's how you can create primers and simulate a PCR within SnapGene. To learn more, visit snapgene.com.